Hey, Uncle here. On behalf of We Are Native, I'd like to congratulate all the youth and youth groups across the country who submitted artwork, creative expressions, and community service project ideas for the first of its kind NIDA Challenge. Your entries demonstrated the inherent resilience of our communities and the power of cultural practices to protect our communities against drug and alcohol misuse. You can check out all the submissions on We Are Native's art gallery for ideas and inspiration on things you can do to strengthen your nation. Each and every one of us can do our part in big and little ways every day. And this led birth to amazing applications and amazing submissions of art, group projects, and different ways to kind of address substance use in their communities.
Hello, Na Jenna Murray Meinanihat. Hi, my name is Jenna Murray. I'm Eastern Shoshone. I'm from Las Vegas, Nevada, but my family is from the Wind River Reservation in Wyoming, and my tribal headquarters are in Fort Washakie, Wyoming. I am the American Indian Alaska Native Fellow at NIDA, and I worked with Kathy Etz and We Are Native to put together this American Indian Alaska Native Youth Challenge program. We had representation from at least 37 different tribes throughout North America, which was really amazing. And of all those submissions for the art project, we had 26 winners, 22 individual projects, and 4 group art projects. We loved the variety of projects that were submitted. We had charcoal paintings, acrylic paintings, interpretive dance and movement, traditional beadwork, and so much more. As far as the community project goes, we had 5 different winners, and I would like to personally acknowledge and congratulate each group for their awesome work. So first we have the Bluebird Youth Group, who proposed a really cool plan for a camping retreat and cultural immersion weekend. We had the Northwest Portland Area Indian Health Board youth delegates, who also proposed sort of a immersion weekend that was a boot camp to create public service announcements. Third, we had Abby Hilton, who proposed a program supported by a really well-researched paper describing the importance of peer support and really leaning on each other throughout recovery. I'd like to congratulate University of New Mexico undergraduate students. We had Alicia, Hannah, Shanoa, and Kira. They planned an incredible 3-day program for high school and middle school students. Finally, we have Shadron Joseph, who proposed an indigenous bow making project to not only just pass on this really incredible tradition, but to allow participants to have a creative outlet, allowing them to become and stay resilient against drug use. I felt deeply connected to this challenge program because I am Indigenous myself and grew up in a community and family that suffers from substance use disorders. So I really felt a personal connection here, and it was really incredibly inspiring. Moving forward, I think what this whole program really means to me is using your cultural connection, you're forming those meaningful connections with your community and leaning on each other through hard times.
I'm Maya, I'm 14 and I'm marijuana free.
My name is Anna, I'm 15 years old and I am marijuana free.
My culture, my choice.
My culture, my choice.
So I just wanted to share that I come from a long line of addiction in my family, and I'm here to break that chain and be better than what I'm said to be because of my family.
My grandma, some of my uncles and aunts live on the reservation.
I think the Native culture is very beautiful.
We are reaching out to different coalitions, and we also are planning on making more videos like this. We also have our youth group that does a lot of like local community kind of things. We started making the video, we had talked about how many dispensaries have been getting put up on colonies especially. And so coming from like a young kid who lives on the colony, like that's what we're around, and that's what we want to say like to the kids, like just because you're around it doesn't mean you have to do it.
Our tribes are trying to help youth become drug free and have a new transition into life.
I love like what we do in like protecting like kids from like marijuana use or any just drug abuse. So I think it's really cool to like get a video out there showing that they don't have to just do that, they can do anything. Even if something's going on and it's hard, go on, do what you love, like sports, musicals, art, do whatever you can to occupy yourself and make you happy, and choose the right choice. My culture, my choice.
Hi, my name is Sierra Bufflehead. I am part of the Ponca tribe of Oklahoma, and I am also part of the Omaha tribe. With most of my family being out of Omaha, it's mostly just me, my aunt, my brother. Phones, Facebook, texting, that's all how we stay connected, how we keep in touch. So I took the night landscape and thought of a filter. A filter people use to make themselves look better, make themselves feel better about themselves. And so if you have a landscape in your life or a dark patch in your life, people would use filters to make it seem brighter, make them feel happier. And so I thought, think of the phone as a brighter future.
Hello, my name is Caitlin Begay. I come from the Navajo Nation. I hope that my art is able to make people want to learn more about their culture and more about their identity and where they come from, because like a lot of my people are like heavy drinkers and like they're really into drugs. So I thought that I should capture something beautiful that maybe they can see within themselves. And my inspiration was like my identity and like what I find beautiful within my culture and my identity. So I included a portrait of myself and a figure of a woman, a Diné woman, and the Navajo wedding basket, which represents like the pattern of life. So you can do it all. It's all up to you.
My name is Kathy Etzen, I'm the director of the American Indian Alaska Native Program at NIDA. So excited to be here today to congratulate the winners. Over the years, as we've supported research on drug addiction among American Indian and Alaska Native people, we've learned a lot about risk factors, but we've also learned about the incredible strength and resiliency contained within Indigenous culture and the amazing ideas that youth have for staying healthy and protecting their communities. This challenge competition was an opportunity to showcase and celebrate that strength and also have youth directly share their ideas about resilience to drug abuse so that we could share those ideas with the world. The judges were absolutely wowed by the art and the ideas that youth had to stop drug abuse in their communities. These ideas can be leveraged to strengthen all Indigenous nations.
Hello everyone, I'm Nora Volkov. I direct the National Institute on Drug Abuse, and I'm very proud to be here with all of you to congratulate the winners of a challenge that actually takes advantage of the richness of the American Indian and Alaska Native culture and their involvement in the well-being of each other, and to use art as a means of communicating our experiences, and in the process, being able to help others. Thanks very much for this opportunity, and I congratulate the individual winners and the group winners.
I'd like to thank Jenna for the creativity, passion, and commitment she brought to implementing these challenges. I'd also like to thank all of the people who submitted entries to these challenges. I'd like to acknowledge your creativity, strength, and passion for enhancing your communities. It is clear that you will all make a lasting impact on your families, communities, and continue to strengthen your nations.